system that CAPS use to qualify the journals is a big advancement in Brazil, because along the years it was minimized the subjectivism in classify or categorize the journal. So the use of bibliometric indicators is welcome in many senses. I think the problem that not only Qualis but Publindex in Colombia, the system in Chile and also in Mexico, is that looking only in some areas in the impact factor, that brings a problem, because it's, as you know, it's the publishing in quartile 1 and quartile 2 of the journals is about 70% of the articles indexed. So in some way, the probability to publish in quartile 1 and quartile 2 is more than publishing 3 and 4. And what happens is, in many areas in our countries, this is, let's say, hiding the problem that the overall impact of the research measuring by citations per article is below the world median. So if it is important to publish in the high impact journal, it does not matter how many citations you receive. So the challenge that we have in this system today is how to combine the impact factor or other indicators, but moving progressively to the actual impact of individual articles. Isidro, regarding the mega journals, okay, we have tried to discuss that, but the journals are so impregnated in the discipline, in these institutions and societies, okay, that we think that to overcome this, let's say, fragmentation, it will be the same strategy that we will need to circumvent the publishers to go to full open access, and that is continuous publishing, okay, to accelerate. So Cielo as a whole is a mega journal, and if you go to preprint, okay, you can have actually a certain continuum in publication, and you solve the problem through other solution, not fighting with publishers or with the journal. So you can combine in some way both worlds. That's what we are trying to do.
Well, thanks to all. I'd like to invite the audience to thank the speakers. And now we'll move to RISIS presentation. So if you, we have now a presentation, 10 minutes presentation by RISIS. So the speakers, please, if you can join the audience. Okay. And meanwhile, Emanuela Andreale from the CNR in Italy is going to introduce the RISIS project and give details on the different databases that have been developed.
Okay. Thank you. Now it works. So I must say that I'm very glad to have the occasion to present RISIS, Research Infrastructure for Research and Innovation Policy Studies, at the end of this roundtable. Because indeed, you can understand that RISIS is in one example of, infrastructure, research infrastructures, for building inclusive collaborative science, as it was recalled by the speakers. Open science, building communities of scholars, and make comparable tools to investigate problems in research activities. So let me introduce RISIS by the objective. RISIS has been designed to promote a distributed infrastructure to advance science and innovation studies with two main goals. So coordinated the existing fragmented data sets existing and open on a free of cost basis them to European researchers. And also develop a new software platform to support the data sets building and treatment. The RISIS is built also having in mind a precise impact that want to be achieved, to provide an improved evidence base for research and innovation policies and for research evaluation through enabling new relevant indicators. This is not an impact which is relevant for policymakers. It's also an impact that we want to produce for researchers, for the improvement of the knowledge. So 15 partners are inside. You find the logos in the last part of the slide, from 10 countries, all public partners, 8 universities, and 7 public research organizations. It's coordinated by IFRIS. There is a quite huge amount of money for this project. That's interesting because it means that the social science research needs resources for investment. It's something that modifies our way of working. There is opening 9 existing data centers and developing 4 new ones, and opening 2 platforms for web-based analysis and for semantic analysis of large Thespis corpuses. This is the introduction. Where these come from? These come from the fact that fields in science and technology innovation studies is an interdisciplinary one. That means that there are several sciences which work together to solve complex problems which derives from the society. This also means, using a conceptualization of Tom Van Raan, that this complex problem generate scientific interesting questions, and they are very useful to build academic research which bring reputation to the scholar. So it means also that we have a wide audience, not only from researchers, but also from policymakers. The second context, point in context is that we have there is a quantitative core in science and technology innovation studies, because specialties such as Science-Metrix, Technometrics, and indicators design are needs data. We can say to some extent that we are a data-driven community, because also when you go to qualitative-based study, we very often use quantitative evidences. Let's think, for instance, to the case studies. The other problem is that I often lack a small scale only. Yet the fields are too dependent on few pre-existing data sets. And last, data and platform are generally owned or they are located in many different organizations, such as individual research groups, companies, and so on. So it's difficult to have the possibility to use them. From since 2000, several efforts has been developed to new data sets, and this movement can contribute to this movement, I think, very strongly, the recognition of the need to move beyond input and output indicator and to move toward positioning indicators. This is one core issue in this conference, because positioning indicators means focusing on organization, means considering indicators as languages to address policy problems, and also means that we need a lot of tools, data sets, which are, let's say, at the periphery of the data collection, because they are not covered by the official statistics. So there is also the need to develop them software platforms for collecting, integrating, and analyzing more data, and increasing the awareness about open science and open access to improve production and circulation of knowledge. So this is what RISIS is definitely want to realize. That's why I think that this presentation is strongly linked to the previous roundtable. And what means open data? Open data is not easy. It's not easy. You don't have simply to think that you put some data on the web and then you have open data. No. Because data is not information. So you need conceptual framework as a precondition to select, identify, and access relevant data. Relevant data seldom stands on their home, on its own. They need to be clarified, enriched, and stored into data sets. What we say about the complementarities, integration, and matching of data sets, hidden very complicated and problematic issues that must to be solved. And most of the time, data are not in the classical quantitative forms. They require textual, semantic analysis and all the other type of visualization. So, the goals. The goals are to consolidate and integrate existing data set, to complement, so it's not a problem only of developing data set, but to consolidate and integrate them, to complement this by developing also new data set on key issue, to build specialized software platforms and to develop tool to favor integration and provide free of cost training and access. That's important to look at activities because activities are ongoing but still open for different users from the participants to the problem, to the project. We have development of shared data resources, we have development of two software platforms, but look, we have two very important activities, which is extensive training and central access, visit and research opportunities, which are now open to everybody. What I intend is that we actually have data sets open to all the community. Everybody that has that want to investigate an issue and find interesting data in these data sets, in this platform, can apply, come, visit, and use the data. But this is something which is paired, but also a very important enabler, that is extensive training. You cannot use a data set if you don't know what is inside the data set. You cannot use a software without a set of data, a platform, if you don't know how it functions. So you have access, but you can also have training for becoming, for enabling you to use the data set. So please visit the website. You will find very surprising that you can now directly go and look and put your hands in the keys and use the data simply by registering yourself and asking and declaring the reason for what you want to do research. And this is open science, concretely. Yes. Yeah, there. Please try. This is an invitation. Okay.
The latent ranking database was available even before the beginning of the RISIS project. And this is the added value of having metadata about the latent ranking databases in your website, but I still have to register there to get access to the data.
No,
this is not open data.
May I complete this presentation? No, it is a very important. It is a very important item, and I understand your point. This is a large debate on this, no problem on this, and I'm not, I'm prepared, let's see. But I would like to, I prefer to finish the presentation and move on this concept of open data. Now, databases and platform. These slides just show you what are the themes inside RISIS, public sector research, research careers, firms, European integration, knowledge dynamics, research innovation policies, and then textual platforms. Each of these themes are covered by one or more data sets, and sometimes there are data sets which are still ongoing, like the European Public Research Organization. This is a very important complement to the existing data sets. The achievement. There is a list here. Coordinated effort for opening the existing datasets, 9 datasets now open. The decision to maintain a transversal team built to follow the use of the open datasets and organize the progressive integration of new external datasets. The third point, which is two very short lines, is It's a large amount of work. The definition of a computer architecture ensuring researchers, a generalized distant access and a dedicated working space. It's a huge amount of work, a huge need of competencies for doing this. So web access for learning about datasets and support to research visits. The implementation of common tool. There are common tools which enable people to use data sets even in the future. Among them, I don't want to be too long in this presentation. I just want to indicate the latecomer, that is the Register on Public Research Organizations. The register is a very simple thing. Let's have a register which indicate with a dedicated ID the existing higher education institutions in Europe, the public research organization, the research hospital, and also it is developing something about the same register on research funding organization. It's not a simple task. You need methodology, you need a conceptual framework, you need definitions, and you need an effort to provide people a key for making matching between data sets easier. There are other activities ongoing. OECD on CIPR, interconnection of OECD and CIPR in innovation policy platform, and integrating with the research community through training courses. There are demonstrators to show the relevance of an interest of integration based on problems and questions. For instance, you can look at the paper that was published about, and it's built using a match of data from ETHER, EUPRO, and Leiden to investigate higher education participation and international in an European framework program and internationalization. And the first choice also to address 4 special issues that you can find listed in the slides, because special issues are really important type of investigation to characterize the dynamics of research and innovation in metropolitan areas within Europe, the polarization process in European project and transborder funding, and so on. So, this is something which implies also the use of techniques and software, which is very important. And to conclude, I don't want to use more time because there is a pressure and I have to answer the question. The ambition is to have a lasting distributed infrastructure, progressively encompassing lost data set and producers. A common good for all the European researchers. This project is a demonstration on how open science can be and open data can be built, and the outcome is to moving toward open science in the field of science and technology studies. And thank you for your attention.
So we'll get a couple of questions and then we'll move to the cocktail. No questions?
No, there is one question.
One question? Yes. Yeah. Alessandro, anybody in the back? Well, in that case, if you want to emphasize the openness.
No, I want to criticize the approach that is described for open science, what you intend open science, what is the open science. Moving toward the open science is a process, is a real process. Open science is not a category, a given category that you have to deal with. Open science is a process, and you have to build with individuals, with organizations, with data, and step-by-step process in which you gain day by day the possibility to share information. You are really concerned about the fact that researchers can contribute to the community with my research, and that's exactly what RISIS did.
Excellent. So let's move from open science to a cocktail in the open air. And so we would like to thank all the speakers and move towards immediately towards the buses.